What's going on, guys? My name is Gamer, and welcome back to another episode of Days Gone. Just casually walking up to Iron Mike's lodge to see what he needs. Wait, what? Advancing the story will temporarily lock you out of the... Oh! Wait, we exploring? Oh shit, I don't know if I'm ready. I never checked in with that dog. Can I pet that dog? Where's the dog? Where's the dog? Is it in here? No, but my gun locker is. Doggy. Doggy? Doggy? There you are. Hoppa! Bubba! Hi, pupper! Hey! Can I pet you? Seriously, I can't pet? Come on, man. You gotta be kidding me. Well, I guess... Well, we got some side missions to do, but like I usually do with most of my gameplays, I usually make a side mission, like, mini-series, but yeah, let's go ahead. Fuck it. We'll be back, right? We should be back. There's too much in this game to explore, so we should be back.
You know a way over the Teelson Pass. You told me once that
I told you nothing. Go on. Oh, I can't help you, Deke.
Just draw me a goddamn map.
After everything you've done.
After everything I've... What about what you've done, old man? Huh? Sherman's camp, the things that you
get out of here. You leave me.
Listen to me. What if you could take it all back, huh? What if you could fix it? And I thought I put Sarah on a chopper. I felt relieved. How fucked up is that? I was relieved. Mike, that's what I've been living with.
And now you're chasing ghosts. You think finding your old lady, if she's alive, you think that's gonna fix it? Make you whole?
I don't know, but I gotta try.
All right. If I do this, what you want, show you the way over the pass, you don't come back. All right, you promise me you don't come back.
I gotcha.
For a while, anyway. It did say temporarily. So I can't come back for a while.
Shit, now I gotta talk to Boozer.
After riding so we're going south. You won't be able to return to Lost Lake for a while. Meeting with Boozer will advance the story, locking you out of Lost Lake as you ride south. Make sure you have the time to turn in any last bounties or visit any vendors. Oh. Well, you guys are lucky. I did that shit off camera. All right, booze. What's blocking the road?
Holy
Boozer,
shit.
Boozer, I...
Last winter, we were up on Farewell Ridge. We were watching the freaks. Thousands, thousands of them. I mean, too many to count.
Yeah, I remember.
All I could think was every one of us, man, woman, and child, are now homeless. Bunch of goddamn refugees. Yeah. World belongs to them now.
We'll survive.
Yeah, we've been doing that all right. Surviving isn't living.
He said it!
Something Jack used to say. Doesn't matter when you hit the road, where you're heading out to, but you damn well better know where you're coming home to.
You know, we never talked about it. While we still wore the colors all this time out in the freak show when shit like this didn't matter anymore.
Yeah, habit, I think. Last two Mongols on Earth, farewell originals.
The biker boys, most badass drifters on the broken road.
Damn straight.
Yeah, I guess we did become sort of a brand.
Yeah. We were a lot of things, but we were never a brand.
We wrote out a farewell. Without Sarah, without Jack, or anyone. I knew that we were leaving everything behind. Everything that mattered was gone. Said this.
You're a nomad again, huh?
Yep, I guess I am.
Come on, Jack. Inside, let's go. If she's out there, you can find her.
Deke, you ready?
Yeah, Mike, I'm ready.
Meet me at the gate. Don't keep me waiting.
Yeah, sure, Mike. Whatever you say.
Well, I don't see why we should keep him waiting. Let's go.
Hey.
Heard Big Mike is taking you over the pass?
Yep.
You really think she's still alive? Billions of people are dead, but somehow she made it.
Hey, we made
billions.
It.
Billions?
If I give up now, if I don't do this, well, then I'm just gonna end up
like us, right? Like Iron Mike, like Boozer? What'd you call us, campers? Yeah?
You go and you find your woman.
Oh, I like you.
You know where to find me.
You need to get your shit straight. Are you a lesbian, or...?
You know what? You know what I think, Deacon? I think that you're afraid to be here. You're afraid to be a part of something. We need you here, and that scares the hell out of you.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, you need to get your shit together. Like, really.
You ready?
Yeah, I'm gonna get the hell out of here.
That was like a low blow. Honestly. That's the way I took it. Like, I helped you get power back on, and then you freaking call me... You basically called me a quitter
this way.
For leaving. I ain't
okay,
leaving to leave.
You.
I'm leaving to go find my woman. Which is why I say again, you're either lesbian or you're straight. Like, you can't love Addie and me. And you definitely can't love me because I don't love you back. I'm just saying.
Took Jack out fishing once. Before, you know?
No shit.
I got one. Didn't know what the hell to do with it.
That sounds like Jack.
Oh, he ran a pretty tight club. Or you boys raised some hell back in the day. I don't think you murdered anyone. Not in cold blood.
It's not murder if they shoot at you first.
You know how many tourists we used to get through here come summer?
A few.
Thousands. Too many to count. Highway'd be bumper to bumper with SUVs and campers chock full of sunburned moms, beer-chugging dads, and their snot-nosed kids. Goddamn rainbow, floppy hats, Hawaiian shirts, and flippy-flops. All summer long they come. Like a trail of colorful ants from L.A. to Farewell to here, nonstop.
I'm glad I avoided road trips out here that time of year.
Where are the freakers? I haven't seen a single freaker. Really? What was that? I didn't even press the touchpad. That was weird. Oh shit. New tunnel? What the fuck?
This is as far as I go. Keep following the trail. It'll take you down the mountain, on into the diamond-like valley. I wish you luck. Hope you're right about your old lady still being alive.
She is.
Well, maybe so. But you gotta ask yourself, Deke, what does it matter if everyone else is dead?
I'll be back, won't I? The hell? Ride to the summit.
You never know what tomorrow may bring. One line next to you could be a memory. I've idolized, I've memorized your face. Just in case the name lasts me eternity. It's a shame that it ain't enough for me. Life's for the living, I won't be given up. You taught me how to, you taught me how to love.
Woo!
Take all I cherish.
You gotta be shitting me. That actually happened.
Life's for the living, I won't be given.
My bike went sideways by itself, by the way. I tried controlling it.
Thank you.
last for the live on you. On you. Even though I know you would tell me to.
If you're out there, I'll find you.
Gunshots?
Mayday! Mayday! Captain Corey, you there? Come
in. It's them again.
Mayday! No one's listening. Damn it, try again!
What the hell?
What the fuck is that? Oh. Where's my weapon? Okay. Rager. Oh.
Get in there.
Okay.
Oh, bitch, you got me fucked up. Can't get me up here, can he? Dude, it has barbed wire around it.
Go, go.
Y'all better watch out, Kobe. Think. Yeah, I got some frags. Where you at, homeboy? Get over here.
Keep going, man.
Yeah. Oh shit, me.
Okay, come on, you can do it.
Oh, I know I can.
Let's get him. He's doing it. Yes.
Let's see.
Watch out! Watch that thing, man!
Kobe. Dumbass. Yeah, that roar's all fine and dandy, unless you roar in the middle of a frag nade. Almost there. Come on. Hi, bub. Oh, shit. Hello! Hello! How you doing?
Almost out. Come on!
Oh, I got it.
You.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus.
I don't know what we would have done without you, man.
Oh, come on. Hey, okay, all right, all right, all right. It's dead. It's cool.
Man of the hour.
Oh, God.
I'm Russell, Glenn Russell. This is Private Mullins. Rick.
Hey, Rick. I'm Deacon St. John. Did you say private?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Deschutes County Militia.
You're not from around here. You come over the pass?
No. I've just been drifting. I came over the salt flats east of Silver Lake.
What the hell are you doing out here, man? How'd you get across the 97?
Whoa. Jesus, man.
What?
This guy just saved your freaking life.
The colonel told us to look out for anybody entering the territory, north or south.
Freaking slow your roll, man. We'll let the captain deal with that, okay?
Fine.
He just killed a freaking ranger, dude!
97?
Come with us. We got a camp just by Diamond Lake. Get you 3 hots and a cot. Least we can do.
Okay, yeah, sounds good. What about Flores? We can't just leave him here.
Oh.
You stay here. I'll come back with some fuel.
No!
Listen, stay here. Use his ammo if you gotta. You'll be fine. Okay?
Following you.
Deacon has military background. Maybe.
You gotta stick with me, okay? Been having some trouble with squatters out here the past few 85%.
Weeks. 85%. Good lord.
Could be trouble.
Okay, got it.
We're almost done.
So, Deschutes County Militia?
Look, man, all I know is they feed me. They want me to salute and yes, sir, I salute and say yes, sir.
How big's your outfit?
To camp out here? We got 100, maybe more. Hard to keep track. Back at HQ,
Freaker
a whole lot more than that.
Yeah, okay. Any women?
Hell, that what you're about? Well, you can forget it. Colonel's got rules about that. Fraternizing. Yeah, that. Look, you pull your weight, follow orders, nobody messes with you. Women same as the men. Don't matter to the colonel.
The army.
I'm looking for some people and a woman that I rode with a year back or so. They would have come over from Silver Lake, and they would have been at one of those Nero refugee camps, I think.
Silver Lake? Jesus, man. Silver Lake's been gone a lot longer than that.
Yeah, it's too goddamn easy to lose track of time out of here, you know? Anyway, you guys, do you pick anyone up? Survivors, I mean, from the refugee camp?
Maybe. Like I said, it's a big freaking army, you know? Ask the captain. He came in across the Salt Flats, I think. He might know.
The captain?
Yeah, Corey. He commands the Diamond Lake Outpost. We're almost there.
Yeah, I can see.
This is it.
It's Corporal Russell. Open up.
Oh.
Report.
Captain, sir, we had him. We did. Found his bike, still smoking.
I bet you lost him, huh?
No, sir. I mean, yeah, we lost him. We ran into a rager, sir.
Where's Mullins? Flores?
Flores is dead, sir. I'll have Mullins with a body.
That'll be all, Corporal. Go get some fuel. Head back to Mullins. You know what to do.
Yeah. Yes, sir. If it wasn't for this man, we'd all be dead, sir. I sort of promised him some food and a safe place to camp tonight, sir.
Corporal, get the fuck out of here.
Oh.
And you are?
Name's Deacon St. John.
Name's Corey. Derek Corey.
What the fuck?
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Sorry, I'm a little tired. I've been on the road for a long time. Your man Russell said you were recruiting.
Are you interested?
I've been looking to settle down. Yeah, find a camp. I'm interested.
No way, dudes. That was
so.
My ring.
Drifting. Hard to say. You lose track of time out there, you know.
Is she actually alive, dude?
So, where'd you get your gear? Ammo?
Well, there's a couple of camps I used to do runs for. Bounty hunting, mostly.
Freaks? Or men?
Both. I had a reputation for being able to track shit down, you know?
Which camps? Where are they?
You know, past the Farewell Valley. It doesn't matter. They're gone now. They're overrun. Russell said you were there when Silver Lake was overrun.
Yeah. That was a shit show, I can tell you.
Any survivors?
Why are you not working hard?
Of
Why
you?
Are you still in my obstacle course? Why are you not finished with my obstacle course? Do you like it that much? Do you?
Someone's angry.
Here. Take this. Militia script. Camp credits. Payment for helping my men. Use them at any of the commissaries.
Okay.
You gonna join up? Stick around. We're getting ready to ride out of here soon.
Getting ready to ride out where?
You said you had some tracking skills.
Yeah, some.
This isn't the life of a drifter. We're fighting a war out here. You sure you're up for it?
Is that the best you got?
I can recruit you. But the colonel is the only one who can swear you in. You stick around. Give us a hand. I'll take you to him myself.
I'll be here.
Good.
Jesus. Jesus, motherfucker has my ring. He took it from Sarah. He had to take it from Sarah because she wouldn't have given it to him. So that means that she's gotta be here.
Why are you not working hard? Why are you still in my obstacle course?
He doesn't look like Militia. Hey, you don't look very militia to me.
Nah, man, name's Wade. Wade Taylor. You can call me Wade.
Deacon St. John.
Holy shit. Deacon St. John? Is your old man a preacher or something?
No.
Man, that is a hell of a name.
All right, listen.
You Wade. See this, man? This is some crazy shit.
Yeah.
Whew. So what, you joining up, becoming an army man, playing soldier and shit?
I don't know. Maybe. Listen, you look like you just came in from out the shit, right?
Yeah, man, yesterday. Okay, yesterday. I've been waiting to see the colonel, whatever the hell that is.
Traveling with some people, we got separated. You see anyone that looked like this around here?
Nah, man. Ooh, she is a looker. I'd hit that, you know. I gotta go, man. They're checking me for lice or some shit. Good luck to you, Deacon St. John. Jesus, what a name.
Jesus, that dude's fucked up.
I love him already.
Sarah, she slapped him in the face. Come on, Sarah, come on. Where the hell are you? You're here. Somewhere. Maybe in these tents. Maybe
something right there.
Nope, not here. Cute drawings. Oh, God. I'm glad Sarah and I never had kids. Losing them must have... Check this one. The infirmary. I mean, with her background, that's where she would be, right?
That's not her.
Damn it. She's not here either.
She's a blonde, not a brunette.
It's gotta be the one.
Baby?
Sarah? Sarah, you in here? Shit.
Not honey!
Oh, God damn it, she's not here. She's not here, but... Right, yeah, it couldn't be that easy. No, could it?
St. John, are you on this channel? Corporal Russell said you had a radio.
Yeah, I'm here.
Meet me at the gate.
On my way.
So we're using the Nero radio. So wait, the militia and the Nero people have the same...
Getting ready to ride out. You still coming?
Ready well, when you are.
Dude, look at that camo you got. Can I get that shit?
Yeah, some.
Open it up!
I love that camo on his bike. I want that shit. Wait, so I'm following this
are
dude.
Are you any good? Can you ride?
Yeah. Yeah, I can ride.
Do you want to join the militia? You're gonna have to prove it to me. See if you can keep up, St. John.
Bro, if we actually find her, I'm gonna lose my shit.
So what the hell happened back there? I mean, it looks like a forest fire, but the stumps are charred, so that means that the timber was cut before it was burned.
You got a good eye. We call it the dead zone. We use the timber to build our barricades, then burn the slash. On the outpost, we can see a horde coming long before it reaches us.
And what? You're gonna burn all the buildings too, so the newts and the swarmers have nowhere to sleep?
You know you're freaks, huh?
Like I said, I've been out in the shit for a long time. So that's your plan, huh? The militia, I mean, to burn everything to the ground?
We're fighting a war out here, St. John. We'll do whatever it takes to win.
A war?
That's what it is, isn't it? A war? You've been out in the shit. You've seen the hordes. The only thing that's gonna stop them is an army. Our army.
It's gonna take way more than an army.
Well, we have a plan. If the colonel lets you join, he'll fill you in. So, Silver Lake, you asked about survivors. Are you looking for someone?
No, not really. I mean, look, there were some folks that I rode with once, and I thought maybe they ended up there.
I thought maybe you were after someone. For a bounty, I mean.
Yeah, no. I tracked men over long distances before, but not this far. No bounty's worth that.
This is it.
Corporal, the captain's here.
It's done, sir. Make sure you make a marker.
Yes, sir.
All right. You two head back to Diamond Lake. Grab, Taylor was his name?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Take him to the colonel. I'll be there in 1800.
Sir?
Military time, Corporal. You're supposed to know this by now.
That's yes, sir. 6 o'clock.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yes, sir.
No.
You find something?
How long is
yeah, it is.
Vasquez. What has Vasquez been with you guys?
6 o'clock.
A couple of weeks, maybe more.
Well, he's been busy.
What the hell?
You guys been having trouble with supply runs, marauder attacks?
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna go on foot from here.
On foot? Why?
Because Vasquez came out here for a reason. I can't track him from the bike.
God.
Where do we start? It's been snowing, so there won't be any boot prints. Come on, I want to look inside the cabin.
Okay, I'm following you.
Driven to extinction. Oh, supply bag. What you been hiding, brother?
You, you
I'm starting
you
to sound like Schizo.
Ammo?
Good lord.
Yes.
This is an MRE. It's half eaten, so looks like your men rode up on him when he wasn't expecting it.
His a dog toy?
Front, which means that he went out the back. Wait, over here.
Oh.
What'd you find?
The fence has been cut. And no rust.
So it was cut recently?
Yeah. Come on, this way.
Let's go.
Hey, hold on for a second. Look. Over here.
Tracks?
Yeah.
Shit.
This way.
Is that deer shit, wolf shit, or freaker shit?
Wait, hold up. You find something?
Yeah.
Bullets.
Shell casing. Recently fired. He stopped to shoot at something. Come on, down here.
Wolf. Hi, bud.
Hold up.
Is it infected?
It doesn't look...
Go on, get out of here!
What are you doing? That ever work for you? Yelling at a wolf?
Yeah, depends.
On what?
On how hungry it is.
Yeah, not bad.
Look out! More wolves! I see him.
Good shot.
Ammo's gone.
Ah!
Slow motion.
That's the last of them.
You bastard.
I want to take a look at this thing. Looks like the MREs weren't enough for your man. Clean gunshot right through the head.
Yeah, the wolves must have heard the shot. Decided they wanted it more than Vasquez.
Yeah, the rest of the pack came at us from back that way, from the east.
You think they chased off Vasquez, leaving one to guard the carcass?
That's my guess.
Come on. You're right.
You guys got a lot of wolves out here? Ones that aren't infected, I mean?
Yeah, we get reports almost every day.
When I was a kid growing up, there were no wolves in Oregon. I mean, a few coyotes, but no wolves. They've been driven to extinction by ranchers and farmers, timber companies.
Yeah, it looks like they're making a big comeback.
Are you Carl Weathers without the mustache?
Hold up.
What is it?
It's a backpack.
It's one of ours.
And ammo.
Looks like they almost got to him.
And a first aid
kit. Away.
Nah. To buy time. He landed on his ass. Tried to scramble away, but then the wolf lunged. Vasquez dropped him. Two shots.
You can tell all that.
Yeah.
Yeah, and not only that, but I can see by the hanging intestines out the wolf's gut and shit.
Wait, get down. A swarm. Near a grave site.
Oh, my lord.
They're scattered all over the region.
Holy shit!
Vasquez came through here. Let's go around.
St. John, this way. Yeah, right there with you. I gotta say, I'm getting tired of running and hiding from these sons of bitches.
You ever take on a swarm?
Yeah,
I've done it before.
You just gotta keep moving.
Well, look, you're gonna join the militia? We must stay focused on the mission. We're not out here to fight freaks.
Being in the shit, killing freaks, it kinda goes hand in hand, doesn't it?
Oh, they're moving.
Put some distance between us and the graves. The cold weather's gonna bring out even more of them. I think they can smell a corpse from about a mile out.
Part of our slash and burn strategy is to find these grave sites, dig them up, and burn them along with everything
else. That is crazy.
Yeah, well, good luck with that. I've seen hundreds of them just in this part of the state alone.
Now we gotta start somewhere. All right, where now?
Keep heading east. Hey, there's a road ahead. Hold up a second.
That one is huge, dude.
What do you think?
Is anyone else tracking him?
Not that I know of.
Huh. Well, then he's either dead, or he's got a lot of friends. You see how his tracks have been overridden by bikes. A lot of bikes.
Okay. Come on. Let's see where they're heading.
You said cold weather brings out the freaks?
Yeah. Cold, snow, rain, hell, even clouds.
Well, like I said before, you know your freaks. When we get to command, there's some people who want to talk to you.
People?
The Colonel will fill you in if he lets you join.
Yeah, I think you said that already.
Look, he runs a tight outfit. I just don't want you to get your hopes up.
Hey, don't worry about me. I don't really give a damn either way. Hey, wait. Hear that?
Yeah, it's coming from the logging camp over there.
Is that on your map?
Yeah.
Well, that means it's also on Vasquez's map.
Come on. If Vasquez is there, what would your strategy be?
Well, he's not alone. We know that from the tracks. What's that militia penalty for going AWOL?
Hanging by the neck until dead. Why?
Well, it means Vasquez isn't coming without a fight.
Okay, we're gonna have to kill these dudes. So, I'm gonna put on my suppressor. And if and when I do get access to my guns, we gonna pop pop till they dead as hell.
Do you see your man?
Yeah. That's him.
Well, looks like you guys need to start doing background checks on your recruits. He seems to be right at home.
Well, let's wait here. I'll radio for backup.
Get your goddamn hands off me!
Oh, this one's a fighter, boys! What do you think?
Oh, come on, Vasquez.
Oh, see about that.
Oh, hell no.
What?
I just got this problem with assholes who hurt unarmed women.
I'm giving you an order.
Order? You see me wearing a red armband? You don't give me orders yet. You do whatever the hell you want.
Mmm, 15. Check yourself.
Who was that? Men coming!
Men coming!
Jeez, I got spotted immediately. Am I now? Fuck it, I'll go loud. I don't think I go loud enough.
Shut up tight.
You can't get far. Wish
I could just casually hold my ear whenever I'm getting shot at. Out of ammo. Soon enough, right? Oh, hi.
Now we got it.
Whoa, what the fuck?
You see, asshole.
St. John, I'm
coming.
Thanks, got him.
Open down.
We need cover and fire.
Open back.
Ow.
Flank.
Bitch.
That last of them?
Yeah, I think so. Nice work.
Come on, let's go deal with your man.
Vasquez? He isn't my man. Not anymore.
Okay. Wait here. Stand guard in case we missed anyone.
Handle him?
He won't know what hit him.
Go ahead. Try.
Oh, I see. Oh.
Hey, whoa. Easy, easy. I'm just here to help.
I don't need your goddamn help.
Okay, I'm just gonna move over here.
Stay the hell away from me!
Hold on now. We're not with them.
You think I give a
damn
who you are?
Okay.
Yeah. Sorry. I gotta get some ammo. Hi, Corey.
What the hell was that?
Just your typical damsel in distress.
Vasquez?
Done. Way done.
Captain Corey? Come in.
This is Corey.
We're here. Heading up the road to the main gate.
Hold your position there. We're coming.
What about the enemy?
They've been, neutralized. Hold your position. Curry out. Come on.
We brought up your bikes, Captain. Thought we'd save you the walk back.
That'll be all, Corporal.
So how'd I do? Did I pass?
Pass?
Oh, you've been watching me all day. I figured this was, what, some kind of test?
No. Nothing quite as formal as all that. As you can see, our pool of recruits isn't what it used to be.
Yeah.
But yeah. You passed.
Yay!
Oh. You ready to meet the colonel?
Yeah, sure. Why the hell not?
The Colonel!
So, St. John.
Colonel Sanders? Serve
before the shit went down. Hey, you know what an MRE looks like. You know how to recon an enemy position. You know cover in advance, tactical maneuvers. So, where did you serve? Marines? Army?
I try not to talk about it, you know? I mean, first year out here, seemed like anyone who used to wear a uniform had a target on their back. I was in the Army, 10th Mountain. I did a full tour in Afghanistan. So how about you? Anyone who's ex-military has a certain bearing. None of your soldiers have it, but you do.
Like I said, you got a good eye. I was in the Air Force 10 years, part of SAC.
There ain't no missile silos in Oregon.
I was on vacation, believe it or not. I was lucky. Before SATCOM went down, I got hourly reports from across the country. You think it was bad out here? Everything east of the Mississippi was overrun within 2 days.
So, are you familiar with this area?
Yeah, I grew up in a town north from here. It's called Farewell, you know it?
No.
Oh.
It sounds like a fitting place to be living at the end of the world.
Yeah, tell me about it.
So maybe you have been here before.
Yeah, I've been here. A few summers back, me and my old lady, or my wife, we stopped by here on our honeymoon.
You got a pic? Of your wife, I mean. Her name was Carrie. We were married 12 years when... Anyway, it was a long time ago.
Hmm. You know, I think this might mean keep out.
Huh? Oh, no, that doesn't apply to us.
Why, because we can't read?
Because we don't obey the law.
Speak for yourself.
After you.
All right. You know, making me a co-conspirator, not very chivalrous.
Chival what?
No, it means, right. I never learn. I'm sorry about that.
Oh my God, you should have seen the look on your face.
Oh, I bet it was funny.
Yeah, if I'd owned a cell phone, I'd have taken a picture.
Well, for just this once, I'm glad that you don't.
Oh, come on, don't start on that again.
Hey, I didn't say anything. You brought it up.
You just did.
I first played this game back when it came out. I remember the date. It's funny that I remember the date because it came out on my birthday.
Where are we going?
Just follow the trail. You'll see that it's not that far.
April 26th. It was 2017 when this game came out.
What would my mom say if she knew I was out on a midnight stroll in the middle of nowhere with an outlaw biker?
Well, I don't know. She'd say, honey, you better wear your sweater.
Very funny.
Yeah, she wouldn't say anything, you know? You weren't supposed to tell them about us, remember?
Oh, come on, Deacon. I said that a long time ago. You know I didn't mean that.
Hey, look, I'm not judging. I'm just... I haven't told my old man.
That's because your father's dead.
Well, yeah, I mean, there's that.
The question is, have you told anyone in the MC that you're dating a nice girl from Seattle and not some bimbo from whatever strip club you guys live in?
Wait a second. No, we don't live in a strip club. I mean, we have a lifetime membership there. That's true, but we don't live there. And second, I did tell them. Yeah, matter of fact, I did.
Wait, you did?
Yeah. Oh, come on, don't sound so surprised. They find your PhDs to be very sexy.
Oh, yeah, I bet. So, you know this is way past my bedtime, right?
Oh, I know.
Oh, come on, stop. I mean, I really do have to get up early tomorrow.
Yeah? How's that going? I mean, you, Well, you never want to talk about it, so...
It's nothing. It's just... it's just this project, and we've got these execs flying in from New York to audit our progress, and the suits at our facility are installing a new lab without even showing me the spec, and...
Ooh, well, I thought you didn't want to talk about it.
Sorry, it's just... You know, like I said, it's nothing. Anyway, thank you for dragging me away from all that.
Yeah, no problem.
All the fireflies. Pretty.
Wait. Is this a pop farm? Is this what you wanted to show me?
Say what?
Well, these are marijuana plants, and that's an irrigation system, so this here, this is a pot farm.
Oh, hey, yeah, look at that, pot farm.
You dragged me out in the middle of the night to the middle of nowhere to show me the MC's illegal growing operation.
Yeah, I mean, you got me. I was hoping that you could give us some tips, you know, cultivation. Put all those PhDs to work on something actually useful.
Jesus, Deacon, what? Okay, I get it. This is not actually what you wanted to show me, right?
No, of course it's not. Come on, keep following the trail. We're almost there.
Ugh, you think I would learn? You think I would learn, but I never learn.
Nope.
God, look at that moonlight. It's so beautiful.
Keep going. We're almost there.
You ever wonder what it would be like if just everywhere all at once the lights went out and everyone could just see the world just like this?
What, you mean like all dark and shadowy and depressing?
I mean the moonlight, the wildflowers, the fireflies. I see you were kidding again. Okay, you don't take anything seriously.
Oh, I take everything seriously.
Oh, yeah, right.
I do.
You do not. Like when I suggested moving some of my stuff over to your place, you pretended that I was joking.
No, that's not true. I pretended I didn't hear you. There's a big difference.
You should have seen the look on your face. And you know, I do have a cell phone and I took a picture. You want me to show you?
My God, you're a scientist. Can we be rational about this?
Okay. First of all I said is that we should think about moving in together. You know, because we get to spend more time together and, you know, take the next step. What's irrational about that?
I have a toothbrush at your place.
Oh, I'm so sorry. You know what? You're right. That is a huge commitment.
Well, I mean, do you know how much a good toothbrush costs?
Okay, see, there you go again. Every time I try to talk about our future, you...
Anymore, they cost like $7, the ones that runs on batteries or whatever.
We do need to talk about it, and we will talk about it, but just hold on for a second, because I want to show you something, okay? See? This is why I brought you out here.
Wow.
Wow, how beautiful.
Was it worth it?
God, yes.
Hey, there's something I've been meaning to ask.
Oh.
Yeah.
Deacon.
Will you...
Will I?
Will you, So is that a yes?
On two conditions.
Name them.
Okay, well, the first one is that we don't have one of those biker weddings where you say that you're gonna ride me as much as your bike.
Done. I couldn't promise that anyway.
Oh, stop. Okay, the second one... The second one is that you never leave me.
Done.
God, did you just break your biker ring off my finger?
You know what? I think I probably Ooh. Did.
Look at it. It's so cute with its little fangs just like clenching onto the chain. You know, nothing says true love like
dog skulls.
Dog skulls. Hey, what does it say there?
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you knew Latin.
Come on.
It's Morier Invictus. It means death before defeat.
Wow, I like that. Well, you're gonna get me like a real ring, though, right? Not that this one's not
absolutely,
great.
Because
I just thought
that's my ring.
Right, it's your ring. Right. Something more simple, without fangs.
Okay.
All right. Shit, I'm sorry.
Damn.
It's the lab. I gotta get it.
Okay.
Hello.
Cock blocker.
Yeah. No. It's fine. I'll be right there. Okay, bye.
Is everything okay?
I don't know. They need me back there. What? I gotta go.
This minute? Like, at this time of night?
I'm sorry. I have to go, but I promise I'll make it up to you.
Okay.
Come on.
Cock blocker.
My wife's name was, Beth. No, I don't have a pick. Let's go.
Now, why would you just downright lie? Grab that real quick. Sorry. I got a shopping list. Also, I'm running out of time.
Not unusual, you know.
I'm sorry, what's that?
To not have any photos of your wife, family.
Yeah, why do you say that?
Back in the day, everyone used smartphones. That's where we kept all our photos. When phones went away, when the cloud went away, our photos went with them.
Yeah, I guess I hadn't thought about that.
My wife, Carrie. Her father was a photographer. Old school. Dark room, chemicals, all that. Too stubborn to embrace the digital age, I think. If it wasn't for him,
I wouldn't have any photos either.
Yeah, well, I hated them. Cell phones, I mean. It seemed like everyone walked around with their noses buried in the damn things. I never owned one.
Interesting. How'd you manage that?
I worked as a mechanic. I had my own shop. Probably had the last landline in Farewell.
What the hell is going on here? This place is serious. If you guys like this video, make sure to subscribe, leave comments in the section below, turn on notifications, check out my YouTube shorts. I'll see y'all in the next episode. But I'm gonna let this play out.
You guys are taking this shit seriously.
Colonel believes with enough motivation and discipline, we can achieve anything.
Come on, hurry your ass up.
I'm going as fast as I can.
Just move it!
Is that your idea of motivation?
The Colonel has set up a work camp on the south side of the island for those unfit to serve. Some of them require extra encouragement.
I'll bet.
Come on, follow me.
Yes, sir.